Street Dancer 3 is like a very long episode of India's Got Talent. A very long episode, without the ad breaks, and with unnecessary harebrained plot squeezed in between its wall-to-wall dance numbers. It's also in 3D, which means that all manner of props are hurled at you, from hats to donuts, while you sit helplessly waiting for some respite. Now, I haven't been an especially big fan of the ABCD franchise, but to give credit where it's due, these films have given visibility to and brought to the forefront some talented dancers who are forever relegated to the background in other films. These movies put them front and center of the action, even giving them speaking roles despite their limited acting skills. But the problem with this franchise is that for some reason, the makers think these films need to be about something more than the dancing, something important, something serious. They couldn't be more wrong. In Street Dancer 3, which is the third installment in the ABCD franchise, the story unfolds in London. Two dance troupes, one Indian and one Pakistani, are constantly at each other's throats. Varun Dhawan plays Sehej, who heads the Indian troupe. Shraddha Kapoor is Inayat, who is with the Pakistani side. Both teams hang out at a restaurant run by Prabhu Deva and spend their time exchanging barbs, squabbling over India versus Pakistan cricket matches, or challenging each other to dance-offs. Then, the important plot kicks in.
तुम लोग नेशनलिटी रिलीजन क्रिकेट के नाम पे हमेशा आपस में लड़ते हो ना ये लोग भी लड़ रहे हैं.
It concerns a bunch of illegal immigrants who arrived in London with big dreams but are hiding out in a tunnel, hungry, homeless, unable to make ends meet. Inayat wants to help them and Sehej is carrying around guilt of his own. So both their teams enter a coveted dance competition. I promise I'm not making this up. The dance numbers in the film are slick, colourful, energetic, and frequently awe-inspiring. There is real talent on display here, and that cannot be denied. But the truth is that these dance numbers are also completely interchangeable. Replace one with another from an entirely different situation in the film, and it makes no difference whatsoever. One of the big items is a performance by Prabhu Deva to his own classic number Mukabla, which makes you wistful for a time when dancing in Hindi films was about fluidity and joy and abandon, and not just back-to-back, over-choreographed set pieces. Returning director Remo D'Souza saves the best performance for the last, when, spoiler alert, the Indian and Pakistani teams unite and the film decides to turn the British dance troupe into the villains. It's all set to the tune of Mile Sur Mera Tumhara. And to be fair, the energy of the performers, coupled with the sheer rousing nature of that track, make this act the film's big highlight. Alas, it's too little too late. For nearly 2.5 hours, we've been subjected to corny plotting and hammy performances. Nora Fatehi is most nimble on the dance floor, but her permanent deer-in-the-headlights expression does not amount to acting. The usually dependable Apar Shakti Khurana is reduced to a slobbering mess as a down-on-his-luck immigrant desperate to return to his vatan. Shraddha Kapoor does what she can with a slim material. Varun Dhawan overcompensates by overacting. Street Dancer 3 left me feeling exhausted, and the 3D, although not bad at all, felt entirely unnecessary. Please God, let them not go in for 4D when they decide to make Street Dancer 4. The thought of sitting in a seat that will move and shake and vibrate to the music is already giving me a queasy feeling in my stomach. I'm going with 2 out of 5 for Street Dancer 3. Next time, make it shorter, keep the plot simple, and just stick to the dancing, will you?